Okay, where's my... Okay. Before I begin, I think I should pass around so y'all can have a look lah. Okay, so you just pass two to the back. Then maybe here. Okay, there's two enough. There's more people here, right? Yeah, so just pass to the back lah. Enough, I just pass behind. Okay. Anything wrong?
Not
so you want me to pause first? Recording? Okay. Okay. So I talk here as well, my PCB business card. So let me talk about the backstory behind this. So like every one of you, you probably already have a paper name card of your own. I did have one of my own also. So around June 2015, when I joined my company full-time after I graduated, so I received this name card. So but there's an issue with it. So can you find this? What's wrong with this name card here? I tell you the clue, it's a spelling mistake. Okay, I'll just tell you the answer. So it's actually here. So actually there's a spelling mistake here. So it's supposed to be, it's missing a B, basically. So because of this spelling mistake, right, then, yeah, you can't give out, I can't give out this name card anymore. So of course, I asked my boss for a replacement. Then he said that, okay, as an engineer, right, I don't normally meet clients as much as he does. So I have a low priority of getting a new replacement name card. So I thought that since I'm an engineer, I can do something about this. I don't need to depend on my boss to get a name card for me. Okay? So I Okay, so I took a look at a typical business cards. So this is how I have from meeting people. So yeah, they're plain, boring, unforgettable. So I'm not gonna have another paper name card like this. So I took a look at PCB business cards. Because I do PCB design as part of my job. So I thought that maybe I should do something like that. So I googled, then I found that actually this concept is not new lah. I mean, people have done it before. So you can see somebody made a flash drive, a USB keyboard, logic gates, and a light ring. So, but the problem is I found that those cards are not really very useful actually. And some are quite expensive, especially if you see the logic gates one. How many chips over there? So it's too expensive to be given out too much. So I came up with this following goals lah. So be different, be useful, appear expensive, but not too expensive. Okay, so let's see the feature goals I have. So I thought of this lah, so my card should have a white LED, ultraviolet light, a ruler, then also to enable people to add contacts easily. Because it's very common, right, when you give your name card to somebody, right, let's say you add a number, you have to manually key into your phone, you know. So I thought, why not have a way to speed things up lah. So I have two methods, the first is a QR code, the second one is through NFC. So NFC is still a prototype, so the cards you're holding in your hands right now, right, this I haven't given them out yet actually. Okay, so the first one, the white LED, so this is quite simple actually. It's a simple torch, PLCC2 package, quite small. So I deliberately put a higher resistor so that to reduce the current use, so increase the battery life. Then this ultraviolet light. So this is actually not the pure ultraviolet in the sense that this is near UV, because the real UV you cannot see. So the current usage is much higher, it's 3 mA. So how does this work, right? What's the practical use of this, right? Yeah, you can see that. So you can actually use it to check whether your currency is counterfeit or not. So in Singapore's $2 note, okay, not just $2 note, $5 note, $10 note, right? There's actually a UV watermark there. Yeah, I believe you all can see here. So you just need to shine there, then you can see this watermark. So if you see this watermark, then, okay, most likely your currency is real. Okay, so switches rise, right? Okay. So I had a hard time trying to find actually a very thin switch because one of the goals of my name card is that it should be as thin as reasonably possible. So I need to get a switch. So this is the switch I've chosen, the 3 mm height. Okay, so there's another switch I thought of was actually a push button type. But actually, after thinking a bit more about it, right, I realized that if you put this name card inside your wallet, right, it'll be very easy to press the push button switch. Then you drain off your battery much faster. So I thought that maybe I should use a slight switch like that. Okay, so I actually have two types of name cards here. So there's a blue and a black. So based on I interviewed some of my friends, what they would think. So the color is that a lot of young people prefer blue ones. Then the older generation, okay, maybe the more like senior level, they prefer the black ones for some reason. Then okay, so I have two types. Okay. So the young blue, right, this is actually a CR2116 holder, but it can fit the 2025 battery. So, okay, so the other one, right? Yeah, so this is actually a 2032 battery holder. So this is actually part sticker here. So this is actually gold plated. So it looks in a way like it's more atas, a bit more high class. Okay, the other difference is the NFC storage, 888, but I'll come to this in a few more slides. Okay. So why two batteries? So because the coin cells connected in parallel, you connect something in parallel, you will divide the current between both of them, right? So the thing is high current reduce overall battery capacity. So you can see from this graph here. So I did a bit of research. So a Nordic Semiconductor, right, they actually measured the battery capacity of CR2032 under different current draining conditions. So you can see here, right, at the highest 3 mA, the overall capacity actually dropped a lot compared to 0.5 mA here. So by putting two batteries, right, I actually get more than 2 times of battery life. You can understand this point, right? Okay. Okay, so next. Okay, so quick contact adding. So QR code. So I think most of you think when you think of QR code, right, you think of a website. But actually QR code can do much more than that. Okay, QR code can be used to embed a V card also. So this is actually the V card text inside here. All this text is inside this QR code here. So actually, that's why you see this QR code is actually unusually dense. But this still can be read. I mean, I tested with a lot of people's phones, still can be read. You can see all the information here. Okay, so this is generated QR code requires color information. So what do I mean by this? So QR code, right, if you're not sure, right, you can actually generate it through any website. Just Google QR code generation website. So I put this text in, I'll get something like this. Okay, but the thing is, right, silk screen is white in color. So here is in black in color. So I can't just put this over here. So I need to do a color inversion. So it'll be here, and this will go in here to flip the color. Because here, you are printing black. But for PCB, you are printing white. So if I just directly go in, right, it will not be red already. So that's why I have to invert the colors here. So yeah, any graphic software, including Microsoft Paint, can do this. Okay, so yeah. So let's have a quick demo here. iOS demo. Because some of you have not seen the card yet. Okay, so here, right, okay, I've mirrored the screen from my Apple Touch here. Okay, so I just launched a simple QR code reader app. Okay, so let's aim it here. Okay, it's just simple. Then all the contacts will be... what happened? Okay, all the contacts will be added in. So you can see my name, my job title, my company, contact details, everything there. So don't have to manually enter anymore. And my client also can get more details rather than just my phone number. Okay, so the next one, NFC. Okay, so this is actually prototype. I only got this prototype card a few weeks ago. So here. So this NFC chip actually contains a V card also. So it has more information now. So it contains my personal email and a LinkedIn account. So the reason why this one why there's a difference, right? Because NFC chip can actually store more. For QR code, right, there's actually 300 bytes optimum. In theory, there's no limit to amount of information can store in the QR code, but the more, if you exceed 300 bytes, right, then your most QR code readers have problem reading them already. So always keep them below 300 bytes for QR code. Okay, so there's actually two sets of chips I'm using here. So the blue card, right, if you can have to, because the chip is over here, it's very small. So this is actually by NXP. So this chip is 888 bytes. So 50 picofarads capacitance. Then for the other one, right, the black one, this is slightly bigger. Sorry. Do I need to pause?
Alright. Is that where you switch out that resolution?
Okay, so I should avoid switching. Okay, then I just present like that. Okay. Marco, okay? Okay, so for the black one, right, this is a separate chip. So this chip actually contains, it can store more information. Okay, so NFC antenna design. So you can see, right, there's actually a very complex way to do it. So actually, I'm quite lazy. When I look at this equation, I'm never mind. So I Google, see, is there any other solution? Actually, there is another solution. So actually, there's this website here. Okay, I forgot to open this website. I Okay, this speaker is the representative of ATS Enterprise over there. So you can see here, right? Yeah, there's actually a simulation. Where's my minus key? So all I have to do is like I put in the necessary values, then they'll calculate for me lah. What are the optimum values? So for my case, right? Here I have certain values already. So 35 micrometers from the PCB manufacturer. So that is fixed. Then the 0.5 mm width and gap, antenna resonance 50 pf. Okay, so for NFC antenna design, right? If they operate at 13.56 MHz, you normally will need a tuning capacitor or resonant capacitor. So that's why they have it here. But the thing is about for NXP chips, right? They already have an internal capacitance of 50 picofarads. So if I were to aim my antenna here, designed to be 50 picofarads, I can skip this extra component totally. I can save the BOM cost. So for my design, for my case here, right? Okay, it's too small to see here. But okay, so when I set all these values in, I get 50 picofarad. That's why in my card, right, there's no extra capacitor needed at all.
What did you change?
Sorry?
What did you change to make that possible?
Okay, so I adjust this value. For example, you see here, the number of turns, number of thickness, right? This calculator will give you like what is the resonant capacity of this antenna. So I just try to match 50 over there. So I adjusting all the other values. Okay, so wait, before that, let's do the demo for NFC. Okay, for NFC, right, your iPhones and iOS devices are not supported. Only Windows phones and higher-end Android phones, because not all Android phones have NFC. So in this demo, right, I'll use my Nexus 6P here. Okay, so nothing over here. Okay, so for this Android screen monitor, there's about 3 to 4 seconds delay. So let me scan my card. Yeah, okay. So it should appear there in a moment. Okay, so just a quick scan and I get all my contact here already. So you can see my name, the contact details. Okay, wait a moment. Yeah, everything.
No photo.
Huh? Sorry?
No photo.
No photo, yeah. It's not big enough, only 300 bytes. Okay, so definitely a very good way to add the contact very quickly. So assembly process, right, because all my components are surface mounted. So I use a stencil and solder paste. So I have this is an example stencil here. For some of you who have not seen one before. Yeah, so you just apply solder paste here, then put the component on the board, then heat up the whole board to reflow it.
Oven.
Yeah, a reflow oven, but for me, I use a hot plate. So it's actually here, hot plate. Yeah. Because the reflow oven is actually quite expensive. So I just use my office hot plate. So for the battery holders, right, I realized that the reflow soldering doesn't work very well because here there's not enough solder applied. So for my test, right, after a few, you take the battery in and out, right, you will lose, you break off basically. So actually I need to hand solder this. Even though this is an SMD component. So actually every single card, right, is really I need to one by one do. Okay, so cost. So this is actually a very common question I get. So 10 pieces, right, is this amount. So if I order more, right, 50 pieces because of economies of scale, so actually it's about here, $10 and $12 plus. Okay, so future work. So of course I'm not going to rest on my laurels. So actually I have this one I thought of. So my future name cards will have this, a bunch of sensors, OLED screen, VLE. NR52 and the rechargeable battery cell. Of course, only for special case. I mean, you can look at this list, right? You know that immediately it will be very expensive already, such a card. So obviously, I won't be giving out this card to just anybody. Okay, yeah. Maybe you give my company a business opportunity.
People will buy your name card.
Okay.
They don't give, they buy.
Okay, I don't mind also. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so actually I've done already some preparation already. So okay, one of the sensors, right, BME280, this is a temperature and humidity sensor. Actually I've designed the breakout already. Yeah, here. Then for others, right, that this IR thermometer, UV sensor, right, I just bought them only one month ago only. So I'm gonna prepare to prototype them. Then OLED screen, yeah. So basically to display details about whatever these sensors have collected. Then VLE, okay. People know me as a VLE person. So yeah, so actually I have got this NR52 module I just ordered from Rigado. So if you read right, NR52, Nordic just mass produced them like I think yesterday, just announced on their Facebook. So but for module wise, you need to wait a few months. So why this actually I emailed Rigado. They said ask them, do they have any sample modules? They say yes, only two only. So I'm now still prototyping. I have to create this actually breakout board here. So yeah, still testing. Yeah, you can find on GitHub. Then power source, yeah, there's this LIRC2450. It's actually much bigger than the CR2032. The capacity is quite small actually. But yeah, rechargeable, I thought, why not? Because if let's say somebody uses my name card, then the battery run out, yeah, I cannot ask them to go and buy a replacement battery every time. So rechargeable ones. So I'll also integrate the charging circuit inside based on this. I mean, I'll find out how this circuit is designed. Okay, yeah, so that's the end already. So, okay, this picture here, right, because I have a bunch of cards here. So the problem is this bunch of cards are like, they fail my QC check, so I can't just give anybody. But if you all want, you all can just help yourself at the end. Hey, the existing cards I pass around, must return back to me. don't take them away. Yes. Okay, yeah, questions?
I understand that in your economies of scale computation, you assume that you produce it for yourself only.
Yes, correct.
What if, say, you raise funds for like 20 people or 100 people that want to have similar cards and just change the screen? How would it happen?
Then provided if, let's say, everybody uses the same components, definitely they all reduce, but the PCB one cannot be reduced because everybody different silk screen, so it has to be sent separately. Different orders, can't be helped, that one.
Is it like a big deal if you print a different...
Okay, the PCB cost...
Unless you silk screen the QR code yourself, as far as the fab is concerned, they're going to be like, this is a completely new board.
Different order.
Or you put separately. Sticker on top.
But then it will come off easily, sticker, yeah.
That's the question. Can you cheat somehow? Like, I know that people that produce these identifiers tended to basically cheat by saying that it's just a very big board and then break it yourself. And then they may have a variance because then you can fit multiple different ID cards.
This is the same, as use for business cards. Yep. If you're getting business cards for a couple of hundred people printed, you don't get them printed as business cards. You get them printed as an A0
exactly.
sheet and then cut.
Yeah. Exactly.
And so it's the same idea. I think you're right.
So you can, I'm not sure, digest the board so that it's easier to break or something.
So I've not actually sent so many cards at one go before. Maybe later Jeremiah will talk about it. He sent 200 boards, right? Yeah.
Because I understand that it's not only for you, but for other people in the company, say. And then you can also ask if anybody here wants, given the reasonable price, at least 20 of them.
Okay, next startup.
For
right?
A special
customer. PC Vista startup. Yeah, business card.
That's the business card that you don't forget. So.
That's true.
Okay. Good business opportunity. You should think about it. Okay, a question?
Can you also read from other cards? Like, you want to share contacts, right? You can also, using NFC, right? But you can also read from other cards.
Okay, NFC, there's a concept of a device rule. So one side is called a tag, and one side is called a reader. So in this, my card, right, the tag, right, does not require a power source, but the reader requires. So if, let's say, you want the two, okay, tags cannot talk to each other. Readers, I think theory readers can talk to each other. So you can't, unless the NFC or a chip on your card itself is also a reader. But in this case, you require actually a power source already. So yeah, it's a bit more complicated that way.
Oh,
question? Yeah.
People talk about things like paper cards, but when you draw the ink, you give a dark pen.
Okay.
Then be like a lot.
Chen Mei.
Stop disturbing King Mei.
So they are more fascinated with then and then rubricating on people.
So is it you want my receivers to draw themselves on the
but those may not last, right? I think. Yeah, the conducting phase I think has a limited lifespan only, a few months only, before they start to deteriorate.
beyond use. They're fairly high resistance, so you can't really use them for anything interesting.
They are okay for workshops and playing with kids, but not for long term. What he's saying is long term.
And some of my chips are actually very small. So it's like the NFC chip, right? I don't think you can use conductive band and draw. For this one, as we can see here, it's
maybe Chibitronics, I don't know.
What's the price for large quantity? I can't remember, but for the, okay, for me, I order, okay, the price for 10 of this NTEC 216, right, I think it's 110 Sing dollars. This is 160. So if we order more, then
definitely should be cheaper.
Yes, many times. So actually, for the cards that I'll be giving, I'm not going to lock those chips. So you can override it, whatever you want.
What's your cost breakdown?
Oh, okay, cost breakdown, right? Okay.
I put the bomb cost ready. Let me find it for you. Here, where's my ASEAN? Okay, cost breakdown, okay lah, I feel lah. Okay, so this is actually the bomb cost here. Okay, so this is one big Excel file lah. So you can, this is all entirely on GitHub lah, so you can just look it up. So you can see here, I've broken down all the costs lah, the UV, SMD, all the chips here. So here, the price is here. So I see the total unit cost, right? I've separated it out lah, unit cost for 10 and unit cost for 50. So there are different pricing quantities. So here, 17 and 12.
So I would assume that for a surface chip resistor, you could go cheaper than
that. Or not? In fact, I could go smaller because the chip I'm using actually is very fat. It's not, I could go to 0805. This I think is 2010. Okay, so the reason I choose so big because it's easier to solder. So big. If it's small, if I make mistake in for some reason I placement wrongly, then I need to clear.
To get cheaper components, you probably need to have some kind of automatic asset.
Yeah, pick and place.
But my quantity is still very small to justify a pick and place. So I still manually do it.
Your business,
I guess this is where you'll have the big economy of scale if you get a bunch of people to do it together with the same.
And but the thing, they all must use the almost or exact the same design.
Exact same design with a different silk screen, you can easily pick and place that.
Like your whole company, for example. I'm not sure how many.
Your next business idea.
So maybe only the front is different, the behind is the same. That kind. Okay, good. Right, good idea.
Actually, you can start Kickstarter.
I think my boss will complain. Okay, yeah.
I mean, it's low volume, so if you want it, you can easily scale it up.
Okay.
And if you get publicity, I'm sure there are people that want special features everywhere in the world. 100 times more than just if you ask the students to do
it.
Okay, so the time, I see my time has run out already. So actually, I should pass the time now over to Jeremiah's. We'll talk about his experience in designing and assembling over 200 PCBs. Okay. So